Hello, Apple Valley High School students. What I'm going to do today is show you how to use software called Roland Cut Studio to produce an image that will be ready to use on our vinyl cutter. So the first thing I'm going to do is go to Google, and I'm going to look for an image that will be easy to set up. And the best images are going to be black and white images that are JPEGs and are very simple in their formatting. So I kind of like Star Wars, and BB-8 is a pretty simple image to make a sticker out of. So I'm going to type in BB-8 and then black and white, silhouette, and then a JPEG, because JPEG images are really easy images to look for and to use in that in our Cut Studio software. Then we're going to go to images, and if you look at it, we get a whole bunch of different images, and the more simple they are, the easier they are going to be to make our stickers. So if you look at this top row, the simplest one would probably be on the far right. I'm going to actually do this one because it's got a little bit more detail, but it's still not too bad. So I'm going to click on that. And then in the screen that comes up, I'm going to right click on that and save the image as. So I go to save image as, and you notice it comes up as a JPEG, which is what I want. And it has a really weird file name, so I'm going to just put BB8. And I'm going to save it to my desktop. I have that set as my preference. So you see it's going to my desktop up here. So I'll hit save. And there it is. Now what I'm going to do is open up Roland Cut Studio. So if I go down to the window and scroll down to Roland, so down to the R's, and then Cut Studio, and I'll open that up. I actually saved that on my taskbar at the bottom. So you notice down here, it's got the big R for Roland. Now, what I did previously is I set up this grid so that they're 1-inch squares. And to do that, you go into View and then to Grid. The first time you ever use the software, it won't be set up for you. So I do go to Grid Setup, and I change this to 1 and 1, and then I click OK, and that's my grid. So I've got about 8-9 inches across and about 10-12 inches if I use the scroll wheel. I can show you how much height I have. Next thing I'm going to do now is go to File and Import, and that will bring in that image that I saved. And you notice that Cut Studio will take a couple different file types. It's pretty limited in what it imports. So I'm going to import BB-8. I'm going to open that. And there it is. It's a fairly large image, but I can change the size of that once I image trace it. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to right click on it and go to Image Outline. And I'm going to let the computer kind of figure out what it needs to do. You can actually go in and adjust these different features. So I'm going to extract contour lines, and those blue lines are going to be the cut lines for the vinyl cutter. I'm going to click OK, and you notice I get those blue lines, and then I have the original image. Well, I'm going to pull this off to the side temporarily, and then I'm going to click on the image. We don't need this anymore, so I'm going to hit the delete key, not the backspace key, the delete key, and get rid of it. So this is my cut image. It's pretty big. I don't want it quite that big. I'm going to have it about 4 by 6 inches. That should be the maximum size that you make your images. So I'm going to go to, I right clicked on it. I'm going to go to properties. And right now it's like 5 by 5.5 by 7.5. I'm going to check the keep aspect ratio. I'm going to change the height to 6. And then when I hit the tab key, it'll be about 6 by 4.5, which is plenty big. And there it is. It's ready to go. So now what I'm going to do is go to File and then Save. And get in the habit of saving your files for our class like this. I'm going to use my last name, first initial, and then I'm going to say it's our vinyl, V-I-N-Y-L, and put the class period, so like fifth hour or whatever class period you're in, so then we can find it if we need to. And then hit save. And there it's ready to go. What you're probably going to do next is upload it to Schoology to the assignment link that I'll have set up for you. And that's all you need to do. So we're basically done. Pretty cool.